chicks that belong to the local goat dairy, Michael Ammon at the Ugly Goat Dairy, actually. And I am raising his crop of Nubian kids this year. They have just done remarkably well. They're currently still on milk, and they're on the real thing. They're on the real goat milk and hay. And their feed is, they're supplemented with fresh start in their feed, and have had fresh start all along in their milk as well. One can easily see, they are in beautiful shape. These little babies aren't even 8 weeks old yet. They're more like six. They're growthy, they're healthy, they're shiny, they're very active, very happy. Their feed is alfalfa hay. They're fed a type of feed called Noble Goat that we get locally around here. The fresh start is top dressed on that feed now. Initially, I put top fresh start in the milk, and they would take the fresh start, of course, as they consume the milk. One thing I've really noticed about them at this young age is how much hay they're consuming. They're really consuming an amazing amount of hay, which of course is what you want to see, because it means that the rumen is working. Initially, milk goes into the abomasum, and as soon as you can start them consuming solid food or hay, it fires up that rumen, which of course is what the animal, the rumen makes the animal. And when you get all of the enzymatic activity going in the rumen, that is a very good thing, and the babies are just going to take off and consume the amount of feed and hay that you really want to see them consume. And that's, of course, going to contribute to their ultimate growth and development. And hopefully, when these little bowlings get into the milking herd, they're going to have a very good capacity for consuming feed and hay, and which will, of course, directly affect their production. So we're very excited about these little kids, and I think they really are a testament to the feeding program and the Fresh Start. This is Jasmine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Jasmine is 3/4 alpaca and 1/4 llama. She's a little nervous right now. Her mom is out running around outside, and she's not with her. But we wanted to show them off for the camera. Mom didn't exactly want to cooperate, but Jasmine's here. These are rescue animals. I got them late in the fall. Jasmine will be a year old in July. They were not in the best of condition when I got them. I put the alpacas on the equine top dress, the equipride, because of the amount of flax and biotin in it for the fiber. It's crucial for these animals, for their fiber, that they get the proper amount of oil, hence the flax. When the shearer came to shear them, I was a little apprehensive because I was having trouble judging their body condition under all of that wool and fiber. But when they sheared everyone here, I was just very pleased and very proud, because they, as you can see, they're in perfect body condition. Just, you couldn't ask for anything better. Not too fat, not too thin, just absolutely where you want them to be. And this little girl delivered a beautiful fiber. The shearer remarked about it, about what a nice, nice fiber she fleece she had. They are getting a Mountain Timothy. Many people say orchard is the best way to go for hay, but these guys have done very well on the Mountain Timothy. As far as their grain is concerned, they get a regular grain mixture that you can just buy at the feed store. And they get a little crimped oats in it. And I throw a little of the goat pellets in there as well for them. And then they get the equipride. They get about the third of the amount that I would give a horse. They're very content, they eat well, they've been extremely healthy, and I'm just very proud of their body condition and how well they've done on the product. So we're a bunch of happy campers about that. Hi, Jasmine. These are also rescue animals. These are Shetland sheep. This little ewe came with, there's a weather running around out here, and black-bellied Barbados all came in this little rescue package. This ewe was pregnant, obviously, which I did not know, so we had a surprise baby. Again, she was carrying a tremendous fleece because she had not even been shorn the year before. But happily, as you can see, once she was shorn, you can see that she's in beautiful condition. Her fleece was just absolutely gorgeous. Again, they came the end of November. You can see they have the block. They also get loose fresh start. Their feed consists of mountain timothy, and when I can get it, I get like to get a grass alfalfa mix for the sheep. And their grain mixture is regular sheep feed. I do have a lamb developer that's has a coccidiostat in it as well that I mix with the regular feed, and they get a little crimped oats too. She was here long enough and had been on the feeding program long enough that she lambed with no problems. He jumped up immediately. She developed a beautiful udder, and as you can see, you know, supplied all the milk that he could ever possibly want. So that, I think, is a pretty important thing to note, given the fact that they came the end of November as rescue animals in less than, you know, the best of conditions. He's been on, Mom was on Fresh Start when she first came, and he's been on it all his life. He was born in March, so you can see how growthy he is compared to her size-wise. She is a normal-sized Shetland ewe. But he is just, you know, a lot of his size, I realize, is fleece. But still, when you see the leg under him, he's very growthy. These sheep I got in March. These are registered Southdown ewes, bred to a Tunis ram. So you can see that the babies are kind of cinnamon-colored, various colors of cinnamon, really, really pretty babies. These two biggest boys here were born in March. And again, as you can see, these ewes are not the biggest sheep in the world by any chance, any means, but these, how big and growthy these guys are. These are triplet ewe lambs, and they were born the end of, mid to end of April. And as you can see for triplets, how you know how well they're doing and how nice and growthy they are. This is their mom. She's feeding three lambs, and she's not fat by any means, but certainly for feeding three lambs, she's certainly in acceptable condition. This old girl's got a little age on her, but she's still growing big ram lambs like this. When they came, I put them on basically the same feeding program as the other sheep are on. When I can get the alfalfa mix hay, I do. Otherwise, they get the mountain timothy, and they get a basic sheep feed. Again, the lamb developer with the coccidiostat is mixed in. Little crimped oats, a little wheat bran, and a lot of fresh start. Everybody lambed, no problem. Several of them I even missed. I missed the triplets being born. they were all up and running around by the time I got down here, which is a really wonderful thing. All of the ewes cleaned immediately. All of the lambs jumped up. Everybody was up on their feet, just literally within minutes. Babies looking for milk. I've had no problems of any kind. No scours, no foot problems, no anything. Just really, you know, a lambing season that you just couldn't want anything better. These girls, again, are registered Southdown ewes. This girl is, she's a youngster, and she lambed these two little ram lambs here that are the youngest ones. These are my youngest lambs. Roughly, I don't know their exact birth date, but they're coming up at about 4 weeks, I think. But what is noteworthy about this is this ewe is 9 years old, and she lambed this big, fat ram lamb here. And, you know, I was here when he was born, and I saw the size of the nose and the feet, and I just thought, oh my gosh, this is going to be trouble, because typically old ewes are where you're going to get your prolapses and that type of thing. As you can see, her udder is hanging pretty low. She was bred when I got her. I'm not sure I would have bred a 9-year-old ewe, but anyway, she was bred when I got her. But she had that lamb with absolutely no problems. Again, everybody jumped up immediately. She cleaned right away. No hint of any kind of problem with her at all. I will not breed her again. She's retired, of course. She's just going to be a big pet, and she can run with the ewe lambs. But I just was so delighted that a ewe of that age, you know, came through the lambing, and the lamb is just, as you can see, he is absolutely gorgeous. I'm even considering keeping him as a ram. He is so, just such a beautiful lamb. As I said, just couldn't be more pleased with how things have gone, and I do really do think that the fresh start was certainly played a really big part in the condition of the ewes and the lambs and the lack of lambing problems. So I couldn't be happier.